Hi, I'm Bun Lai of Miya Sushi, and I'm here to answer 6.5 questions. We don't serve 9 out of 10 types of seafood that you'd normally get at a regular sushi restaurant. Our rice isn't white rice, it's a combination of multi-grains that are unsweetened. So in a nutshell, it's not only healthier for your body, but tastier and also planet friendly as well. We were by the ocean when you told me to say, girl, don't you ever go. You know, the other day someone came in and said, hey, this isn't sushi, you guys don't have a California roll. But I live and do business in a way that's in line with my values and my principles and my ethics, and that's gonna lead me to where I wanna go when I couple it with my artistry. I've made choices with this business, and thank goodness with my mother's support, that was really, really difficult for the business, you know? And each time the business would take like a little bit of a nosedive. You know, like when you get rid of tuna and you get rid of shrimp and you get rid of farm salmon and yellowtail and eel and stuff, there's going to be reverberations to that. And but what I've actually learned is that when you make a decision that's a difficult decision based on doing something that you truly believe is right, for me, it's forced me to become much more creative in survival, and it's made me a better artist than I could ever have imagined I would be. When I create a new role or a new recipe, it's no different than when an actor immerses themselves for method acting into the lives of their characters. I try to immerse myself into different cultures and different ways of thinking. Food is a way of understanding other people. You know, in ancient times, you'd have people come into your house and you'd share, break bread with them, so to speak, and it was a way of creating trust between parties. My menu is a love letter to humanity because I'm interested in people of all different cultures, and the one way of getting to know other people is through the way that they eat, and our recipes are inspired by the way people cook from all around the world. You know, in Japanese we say itadakimasu before every meal, you know, and in many cultures we say a prayer or we say something in honor of the meal. In Japan, when you say itadakimasu, you're honoring not only the farmer or the fisherman, but also, you know, the animal or the plant or the universe that provided this meal for you, you know, so that you can nourish your body, then you can nourish your soul. So for me, what I do is that I always count my blessings. So, you know, every moment that I live, hopefully, is a joyful one. I've always been lost, and I'm still lost, and that's the truth. You know, I'm just kind of wading through it all. And like I said, you know, I used to be a wrestler, and you know, you go into the match, and your goal is to win. You know, but you may not win. And you don't go there with a game plan. You just go in there to fight and see what happens, you know. But leading up to that match, you train, you know. You make sure that you're in shape for it and you're mentally and physically in shape for it. And then the battle will take you where you're supposed to go, win or lose. Yeah, it's hard to say in a couple of words, but my career is no different than the way I grew up, which is that I used to play in the woods and, you know, swim in the ocean, and I love nature, and I'm interested in science, and I'm interested in art, and I love people, so I'm doing all those things, and I'm able to make a little bit of a living doing it as well. You're running around with a Yanomamo and, you know, in the Amazon jungle and shooting poison frog darts, so, yeah.